Let's start with a normal person that's just looking to detox, looking to improve and optimize their health. What would the usage be there? Because you have certain times, and I've even been asked, because I've been posting the pictures of me sitting with my head popped out of one, and people say, "How, you know, what's the temperature and how long do you do it?" And I'm like, I change it around and I go 20, 30 minutes if I have time at 150, and then I'll do 120 if it's after workout and I'm ready, really heated. But what would be your kind of recommended just go-to setting to start using this? How many times a week also?
Great question. Man, you're really knocking it out of the park today with these questions, frankly.
Oh, thank you.
Super happy. When you get, as a company, I don't believe it's enough just to make a really cool device. I think it's important to understand how to use the device in order to get your optimal result. And when you buy an infrared sauna or you buy a healing pad that has infrared technology that we make, we also send you a best practice optimal reference guide, which is about 14 pages. Don't get scared. It's mostly pictures. Okay. And it talks about the optimal time to use it, what kinds of synergistic things you can do with sauna to optimize your detox response. But with that, our company, and I organize this on my side. So we kind of separate church and state here at Therasage. I manage the device development team and engineering part, and also the health science part. And so we have a team of health practitioners, and we offer a free coaching service. So when you buy a sauna, you can get onto our website on the top and make an appointment. It's free for a 15 to half an hour consult, where we take that broad brushstroke of starting reference point in the guide, and then we dial it in based on your personal needs. Because all of us are different, and how our bodies interpret infrared sauna and sunlight or sun energy is different. Mm-hmm. And we're living in a pretty toxic environment in general. We're sort of cognizant coming in that everybody's coming in at a little different level of toxicity. And because we want to make sure that people have a great experience and really realize their personal health goals, whatever that be, it could be a chronic challenge, or it could be, hey, I'm a biohacker and I'm strong as a bull and I want to stay strong and not have to deal with hospitals and clinics and all that stuff, you know? So it will never replace, by the way, you and what you guys do in your clinic. These are all adjunct ways to maintain optimal health, which is super, super important. And I'm sure you've probably seen this because you guys are one of the places that actually fix people. And so you don't have to worry about people standing online to get into your practice to know what you guys are doing. Because when you fix people, that is what I consider a more personal and original approach to the normal sort of Western allopathic approach. You don't want to keep people sick. You want to get them well. And basically that goes viral, because when I find out that your clinic is one that fixes people, then I just want to send everyone I know there. So that's the goal. All right. So your question, which was, I forget now.
Well, now I'm drawing a blank because I was moving on to the next. No, it was about the, oh man, infrared sauna. I had it written down and I crossed it out. But let's go into the usage now of the infrared sauna, right? For a normal person. Yeah. And I also want to talk about next was for someone, let's say like a Lyme patient that is getting therapy already, right?
Right.
So that was the split here. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's start off with the basics. So with that optimal health guide, it gives you a startup, and the startup goal for the first few weeks would be the starting temperature, default temperature, which is 125 to 130 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 minutes. Now, that being said, honestly, if you came into my clinic and you presented yourself as someone that was somewhat fragile with symptoms, your protocol might be maybe 115 or 120 degrees for only 15 or 20 minutes for the first week. And rather than doing it every day, which is what I would prefer, we might start you at 3 days a week. And then the second week, graduate to 5 days a week. So what we tried to do, I might be showing my either age or dating myself in a way. There's, as good as you and I might be as practitioners, health coaches, or doctors, the best doctor on the planet is the doctor and the little voice that's inside each one of us. Unfortunately, most of us ignore that voice. Okay. And what I try to do in our coaching service is to get people to be more sensitive to that voice. And I'll tell you how that plays out. So let's say your goal is 130 for 30 minutes, right? But you get into the sauna and for some reason today you're starting to feel a little symptomatic, or what we call a detox response, which would be lightheadedness, dizziness, nausea, headaches, vision, hearing impairment slightly. Could be a histamine response, which might be a blemish or a rash appearing on your skin. These are very common in the detox world. And again, we assume everybody's toxic. So the perfect analogy would be if I was your swimming coach and you were deathly afraid of swimming and that you were going to drown, I wouldn't throw you into the deep end of the pool without a life preserver, tell you that I was going to go get a Starbucks, be back in a half hour, and expect you to survive. We kind of go low and slow. And we try to get you to tune into what your body's saying. So for instance, another live example, let's say you're perfectly primed and you're doing 130 for 30 and you're ready to kind of go on to the next step. And then you go out tonight for dinner and you have a meal and you don't realize, because you can't taste it in the meal, that the chef was using some oil that was just turning rancid. And so you actually ingested a whole bunch of mycotoxins. So your toxic level actually went up. But I don't know about you. I have no meter somewhere on my body that shows me my toxic level. You know,
nope.
The only way we know is when the body actually gives us some kind of sign. And the sauna will do that, because as we were saying earlier, the reason why I centered on infrared sauna is because these wavelengths, when it creates that resonance or that vibration, it actually breaks all of the covalent bonds between where the toxin is being held in the body and your tissues or your organ, muscle mass, wherever. It breaks that bond, and now the actual toxin cascades into your interstitial fluid or your bloodstream, okay, which is really priming your body to filter it to get out. And we have primal filtering organs, your liver, pancreas, large intestine, kidneys, your lymphatic system. You know, these are all designed to grab toxins and pull them out. I would love to have you tune into that part of you, that inner voice. And we only know that when we get tested. And so what we do on our coaching service is we actually track you for 8 weeks. So every 2 weeks, we have a quick little call, 15 minutes. How are you doing? Tell me what's going on for you. Are you experiencing any detox responses? And if you have a detox response, and let's say it's our live example, the next day you get up and you're 20 minutes into your 30-minute session, you start feeling a little uncomfortable. I don't do what they do in gym class, at least they did in my gym class when I grew up. No pain, no gain. No, it doesn't work that way in the detox world.
Yeah.
When you're feeling that symptom, your body is telling you that you've now dumped a whole bunch of new toxins into your bloodstream. Your bloodstream is a closed system. It gets up to your brain within a minute or so, and your brain responds to a higher level of toxicity by acting woozy or disoriented. That hence lightheadedness, dizziness, nausea. Okay. And when you feel that way, the idea isn't to continue to keep dumping more toxins into your bloodstream. You stop your session, you drink a second glass of water, which is 8 to 10 ounces, that dilutes the toxic burden in your body. And then usually that feeling dissipates within, maybe 5 minutes or so. And then you hit it again, either later that day or the next day. And usually, you know, you peck away at that toxic load or that little toxic hurdle. And usually by the next day it's gone, or maybe one day after. And then you're back on the road to, you know, whatever our treatment plan is that we work through. So generally it's a broad protocol, 3 to 5 days a week. The goal is 30 minutes at 130, give or take 5 degrees. If you're a little more fragile, it might be 3 days a week at 115 or 120 for maybe 20 minutes. And then we just sort of dial up to that 130-30. We kind of stay there, see the body stabilize. And then after that, we can really start, you know, diving in deep. So for an advanced person that's chronic like Lyme, it may take us 6 to 8 weeks before they can be in sauna for 45 minutes at 150 to 160 degrees. It really depends on you and how your body interprets it. And that's the individual part of what we do in our practice, because as we're all special, you know, and we're not looking to homogenize and get a one a day vitamin out of this process. We're looking to show you all the rules, guide you for something like 6 to 8 weeks, get you in the cockpit of the plane long enough so you feel comfortable flying the plane, you have no fear. And then we'll always, we sort of kind of fade away into the background. We'll always be there to support you if you have a challenge, but we really want to arm you with all the information and education so that you can really, you know, understand the power of sauna and always, depend or use the sauna as it serves you so that you achieve your optimal health.
Yeah, we are all so unique, and we have to take that into consideration when we ask these types of things. What should I do, right? You're going to be so different than the next person. And you got to be able to understand who you are and utilize that intuition and that knowledge of yourself, that inner intelligence that guides you through that process.